3, 2, 1. Well, first of all, Alex, I'd like to thank you for coming on the show. I greatly appreciate it. I know you're very busy, got a lot going on, I'm sure.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, of course. So you said you're in college. What are you taking?
Yes, I am. I am in school after a 7-year break for sports and health sciences.
Oh, very cool. What kind of goes along with your interests, as far as competing and everything like that? How did you get into like training and competing?
So I was an athlete literally my entire life. I started softball at the age of 4 in Little League. My mom put me in right away because my mom was a softball player growing up. And I played all the way into college. I also played volleyball. I ran indoor track. I played basketball. And after college softball, I was just like, what else can I do? I need something. And we would work out in college, but it wasn't anything like serious. It was kind of just like coach made us go. So we were there, just there to be there. And then I got into a serious relationship, and then that ended, and I needed a way to like focus all my energy on something else. So I went back to the gym, and I went in with the mindset of like, I'm gonna be the finest ex this man has ever had, and blah blah blah. And then that's when like Instagram like first took off, and the very first competitor I ever saw on there was Jessica Reblo, and I saw her competing. And then ever since, like I had it in the back of my head, I didn't know if I was gonna ever compete, but I was just like, I want to look like her. So I like made it my goal to look as best as I could and get in the best shape that I could be. And then I decided to take a stab at it and did my first competition in July, or what was it, April of 2016 before I deployed.
So what division was that in?
In bikini. I did
Bikini.
MPC.
Got it. So have you since then, have you like competed again more
Yeah, I
recently?
have. So I just finished my 12th show.
Oh
I
wow, so
did North Americans, and
okay.
that was a very, very
Still
fun show. I
in
didn't walk
bikini.
out pro, but I walked out like feeling very, very proud of myself.
Yeah, you feel like you made improvements
Oh yeah,
over the
definitely.
years. Got it. So you got into the gym basically because like from mindset just looking better, and then you decided to just go ahead and start competing after seeing an athlete. That's that tends to be the case. So like were you were never like really into weight training? It was more just like you said, just for just part of a sport. Is that kind of how it was?
Yeah, just because I was so competitive growing up and I needed something because I've always had sports. But then once I finished, or once I got out of college, I was just like, oh, well, damn, like, how else can I be competitive? I need something. Like, I just have that drive in me to always be competitive in something. And so, like, when I saw the Instagram stuff and fitness taking off via Instagram, I was just like, wow, that looks fun. I don't think I can hop into it now, but maybe one day I can do it.
It's interesting because like that's kind of like the mindset that a lot of athletes have, especially like you'll be in athletics all your life, right? And then you'll get to a point like as an adult, there's really not much you can like do unless you're at that level where you go like, pro like or something like that. But if you're just, a good athlete, but you're not quite at that elite level where you went pro, it's like you don't have anything else after school. So it's kind of like, what do you do? And so a lot of athletes that I talk to, bodybuilders and NPC and IBB, that's kind of how they got into it, is like they were looking for something to compete in. And this they just kind of fell into it, fell in love with it. So have you ever thought about like going to a different division, or was bikini just kind of like what you wanted to do from the very beginning?
So I wanted to go directly into bikini just because I didn't know. I like it's bikini is like an entry level, especially when you're just getting in, I would say. And I have a very small frame. I'm very small. I'm only 5'3". And I would love, oh my gosh, I absolutely love to jump up into figure. But I am tiny. I am small. So for me to jump into that, I would have to take some serious years off.
Yeah, to try to put that muscle mass on, that would be a attack. How much have you like gained muscle in bikini like since you started?
Oh, most definitely. So I was that sort of athlete where I was that skinny fat. So I was always very, very tiny, but like I had no muscular shape whatsoever. Yeah.
Were you are your parents like smaller like people? Is that like where you get it
So
from?
my mom is very small. My mom's only 5 foot. And then my dad is only like 5'9", 5'10". But my dad is Polynesian, so I don't know if you've ever heard Tongan.
I don't, I mean,
Like
like it sounds
Samoan,
familiar,
Pacific
but
Islanders, like, so they're all very big on my dad's side. So they've got the very big muscular build, while my mom has like the very small, tiny little Italian Polish genetics.
So you took mostly after your mom.
Yeah, in height, but then like with my, honestly, with my strength and muscle definition, I definitely got that from my dad's side.
That's funny. So how did like being smaller in all those sports, like did that, how did that affect you? Like how did you have a hard time like with taking, picking sports up, or was that, did it come easy to you?
No, it was pretty easy. I think it was honestly because my mom was my coach half the time for my
Oh,
softball.
that
So,
helps, doesn't it?
yeah, it helped a lot. And I think my mom realized that like once she was done with high school sports, like she had a kid and now she didn't have anything else to be competitive with. And so she was just like, oh, let me put my daughter into this. And like she was the same way once I finished college softball. With my little sister, she got my little sister right into it, and now my little sister plays softball.
That's funny. Yeah, she's living vicariously through you
Oh yeah,
guys.
most definitely. And it's the same now with my competing. Like, so when I first got into it, she wasn't very, she it wasn't that she wasn't supportive, but she didn't know what to think of it because she just saw it as me just starving myself and always staying in the gym. But then once I started winning shows, like it was like my softball season's all over again. She was my number one fan and supportive of everything. And even so at North Americans just this past 2 weeks ago, she was crazy supportive and it was just awesome.
How did that's awesome to have. Like you really kind of need that, like somebody to really support you, especially in something like bodybuilding, where like you mentioned to your point, it is hard to prep. You're eating less food, you're irritable. It's like it's always nice to have someone in your corner,
Definitely.
So how did the prep for the Americans go?
Honestly, it went pretty good. I started in February, so I wasn't actually planning to do North Americans. Myself and my husband started prep around the same time because my husband preps too or competes as well. And he did the show in St. Louis, I believe it was like the first week of May. And I went in with the intentions to do junior nationals in Chattanooga.
That's in my neck of the woods. I'm in
Oh,
Tennessee.
really?
Yeah, I'm in
Nice.
Nashville.
I went to Nashville. I stopped there on the way back. I had such a good time in Nashville.
Very cool. Very cool.
Went into that show. Honestly, didn't tell anybody that I did junior nationals. It went horrible. It was the worst show I've ever done. Not in the sense of the show itself, but the worst placing I've ever gotten. And it was a really humbling moment for
What do
me.
you attribute that to, if you don't mind me asking? Like, you think it is just not enough time for prep, or something went wrong?
I didn't come in nearly as conditioned as I have in the past. And I really pushed, so I was very, very confused. My coach and I, we pushed a lot, and I don't know. We definitely needed more time in my body, I guess, just wasn't responded the way that we normally do. Or that the way that it normally does. So I don't know. And I was pretty stressed going into that show. What not leading into the show, but once I got to Chattanooga, just the environment around me was very, very stressful leading in maybe like 48 hours into this show. And I just looked my abs. I probably looked like I could have dieted for like another 6 weeks.
It makes a difference because of all the hormones and everything, being out of whack, it can make you look, because you're essentially like, unlike other sports where you're competing, performance based. You're in bodybuilding, it's the way you look. So your looks can change from hour to hour, you know. Oh, so definitely. it's so a stressful environment like that can cause you to. I've heard people of having abs and then like right before the show losing them, like not just completely flushed, you know. And it's, and you know, it's unfortunate, but a stressful environment will do that, especially for women too. That's
definitely
common.
And so, I had never experienced something like that happening. And it was just a lot of stress surrounding me. And my coach was actually there. He flew down from Rhode Island to come and support me. And he tried to, like, be as calm and, you know, as supportive as I could be. And he helped me a lot, him and my husband. But it was just, like, everything else around me was kind of just going in. And it got to me, definitely. And it showed on stage. I felt I had a good time. Just it didn't obviously go as planned.
Right. So then after that, what happened?
After that, we decided to keep going because I wasn't going to let my placing at Junior Nationals defy me. Mm-hmm. Cause it was really humbling and I didn't let it get to me. Everybody else actually that was with me was more upset about it than I was. Mm-hmm. I was just like, listen, things don't happen. Not every day is going to be a good day, but it's not going to define you as a competitor. So get your head back in the game and keep going. Well, and I felt good still. I wasn't burnt out or anything. My body, although like it obviously didn't respond the way it normally does going into our shows, I wasn't done.
Yeah, I mean, that's the championship kind of competitor mentality, right? That's that's what you want. But you can't allow a setback to, you know, to jeopardize everything else in the future. So you just kind of take it and keep going, learn from it and keep moving forward. So so you know you had that mentality, so on you went, I guess, to North Americans. How did everything go from there for the prep for that?
So it was going into North America, it was harder than probably I've previously, because I'm also in the military, I'm active army. And there's just a lot going on in the world right now. And my job just, I had a lot of late nights at work and very early mornings with the military. And trying to fit in prep and getting in my cardio and making sure I can take a second to eat. And making sure I'm still sleeping and training and all that at the same time, which it was very, very hard. So there was a lot of stress going into it, but I handled it probably better than I did the weekend going into Junior Nationals, honestly. I made it work, and it helped having my husband being extremely supportive with it. My coach, he understands my lifestyle with the Army, and as much as I want to put prep and competing first, I'm a soldier first. It sounds corny, but that's my job.
I did what
I had to do, and I made it happen.
Then, what's the most difficult part of having that kind of schedule for work and trying to compete? Is it the eating or is it the training? Like, what was the most hardest thing to get in?
I would just say the training. As much as I love it, I was just very fatigued with everything going on at work. And then doing multiple training sessions, whether it's our regular Army PT, I have to get up and do it with my soldiers. Finding time to get in my cardio. I would wake up before I had to go to PT. I would do my cardio during lunch and try to just break it up so I wasn't having to do everything all together, be in the gym for like 4 hours, basically.
Do you think that having that kind of experience in Chattanooga where you were kind of stressed out and things didn't go well, like helped you with this, since you were, you know, still kind of under stress, but did it help you to like kind of manage it better?
No, honestly, you know, I think what helps me is learning how to be resilient. And again, this sounds super corny because the military, just the Army specifically, I know that we talk about being resilient all the time. I've just learned how to be dedicated and focus on what it is that I really want to be and bounce back from any type of adversaries there.
Yeah. No, and I completely understand that. I was, when I was younger, I was involved in like wrestling, and our practices were very grueling, very tough. And it's like, And you learn how to just keep going no matter what when you're cutting weight, all the kind of crazy stuff that we did and still keep, competing and everything. And then kind of once I got out of it, got a little older, I realized later how resilient that made me compared to other people. Sometimes you don't even notice it, but it's like you just through that process, you just become much more hard, like harder, just much more developed.
Yeah,
So than other
definitely.
people that don't have to deal with that or don't or choose not to deal with it, So, what, how did you do in the North Americans?
So I placed, gosh, what did I place? 14th, I think. And there was 28 girls, I believe, in my class. So I actually did North Americans last year as well. And I placed 10th there last year. This year I placed lower, but I came in with a much better package and much better physique.
Were there more girls this year than there were last year?
No, there was actually more last year. I
Really?
think last year in my class there was 38 girls. This year, so there was about 10 girls less. I placed lower, but I felt better. Everything was just so much better this year. And that's why, like, even though it didn't go as planned, I didn't walk out as a pro, I still walked out of there feeling my best and super proud of everything.
Bikini is tough because it's one of those divisions that it's hard to I don't want to say a lot of girls look the same. That's not really a fair assessment, but there's the details are so small that it's you can go between 10th and 14th and not really like and like you said in your case you look better, you brought a better package, but you went to 14th because there's just such the girls in the divisions are so close together. It's hard, a few placings you can easily switch between those as opposed to like men's bodybuilding or something like that where it might be more clear cut winner, clear cut. So anyways, but so what's the plan now for you that you're after North Americans?
Right now, I am reversing, and I'm going into my improvement season because I'm not going to take anything other than a pro win my next show. I'm not going to accept it. So I'm going to take whatever time it takes, however long, whatever I got to do to get there, as long as I can still, keep a good positive mindset about the whole thing. And still, I have military obligations that I have to fulfill, and there's other stuff that I want to do with my life. So until I get to where I need to be, I won't be stepping on stage.
So you're just gonna improve until you know that you
Yeah,
can.
I mean, I would love to, oh my gosh, I would love to come back next year. So NPC Universe is a show that I've always wanted to do. Always wanted to go pro at that show, but I've never had the opportunity to actually compete there. And I know that they're in July of 2022, but that still falls short of my 1 year minimum that I want to take off, so I won't be doing that show. I don't know, maybe nationals next year, NPC Nationals. Depends on what happens. It used to be in November, and they moved it to December with COVID last year, and it gets in December again this year. So I don't know. I'm taking at least a minimum of a year off, definitely. But I'm not gonna lie to myself. I don't think that I deserve to be a pro this year. I mean, I try to bust my ass to try to get there and earn it. But when I look at the lineup of girls, I think I deserve my placing.
I mean that's that's fair. And that's also smart on your end to wait because sometimes what happens is people will turn pro and then this happens often in the with men. They'll turn pro and then they're not a good pro because they made it just they were just enough to turn or maybe they hit a the right show, but they're still not as developed to compete legitimately as a pro. So it's smart to come in really good, so get your pro card and then already be competitive at the pro level, instead of just waiting because you'll see that the people turn pro then they'll wait like years. Sometimes they don't even come back, and that's just because they're not developed yet. So
And that's my plan. Like, if I feel like if I'm putting in so much of this work, why try just for one show, turn pro, and then go back to improving? Like, I want to be, if once I turn pro, I want to be competitive with pros and just roll into the IFBB pro circuit. Like, I don't want to have to take time off and whatnot. So I'll take whatever means necessary to get there and take it day by day.
Yeah, for sure. Did they give you any input into like your the way you look? Did the judges tell you anything? Did they give you
Actually,
anything?
yeah. So I just got my feedback back. Let me look at it. It just came in this week, actually. So they said, sorry, my phone's
No,
dying.
you're fine.
Oh
Take your time.
gosh, it's not gonna load now. Yeah, it's not loading. It's just saying stop downloading. Basically, to sum it up, they said that my frame was pretty good, that I just need to be bigger.
Bigger.
I'm,
That's
like I
funny
said,
because
I'm
you don't.
small. I need to build size. And they wanted me to come in just a little bit more conditioned. But if I have more muscle, I'll have a more harder look when it comes down to leaning out and whatnot.
Yeah. It's interesting because like bikini has become so much more muscular in the recent years. You know, like some of the bikini girls now, years ago, you know, they would have caught like been figure, you know, but everybody's getting, you know, a lot bigger. So it's interesting to hear a bikini competitor get a feedback like you need to be bigger, but we're at the point now where like that's happening. Girls coming in a lot more muscular.
I love the more muscular look. I think it is amazing. I personally don't like the model type of look, I guess.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
But I love the harder, muscular look on females. I just think it's so appealing to the eyes, at least for me. And if you ask my husband and like my close friends, they would agree and say the same thing.
Well, I think there definitely is something to being like muscular. It kind of implies that you look, when I see somebody that's built, I'm like, wow, that person is like puts in a lot of hard work, so, you know, into the way they look and into training, and you know, and they take it seriously. It's like you see somebody who's just, you know, who's just naturally kind of just pretty, you know, like the it's like, okay, well, yeah, I mean, but you didn't, you know, what if you didn't really work for that? That was just kind of how you were born. But when you see muscle, you're like, you know, that person worked for that, you
Yeah,
know.
definitely.
So yeah, very true. Do you do any like training, coaching yourself? I know you're very busy.
No, I don't. I get people honestly reach out to me all the time. I just personally, I don't have the time
Yeah,
for
I figured.
it, and I'm not educated in it enough to go out and help somebody. I don't want to potentially hurt somebody by doing something that I'm not 100% knowledgeable about, you know? It's one thing to know things for myself and train myself, but it's another thing to put somebody else's safety in my hands.
There's a lot of that, but you know, I'm sure you're aware, but there's so many coaches out there that really shouldn't be coaching. And you know, a lot of people have been essentially hurt, you know, by the way they run their athletes, you know. Sometimes it happens. You know, I don't want to name any names or anything like that, but I've had a girl on my podcast, and her and her husband were both coached by this guy, and he was, I mean, it turned out to be terrible. Like their bodies completely were essentially ruined. It took him a while to get back to like more normal state, you know. So you definitely don't want that for sure.
That's horrible. And that's the thing that I've always been scared about. Like, even if I did go into coaching or go ahead and get a dietitian degree and whatever else to, potentially be a coach, I still in the back of my head be like, damn, am I knowledgeable enough to put somebody else's life in my hands potentially?
Yeah, no, for sure. But I mean, but you're probably with that mindset, you're probably the best person to do that. It's like
Mm-hmm.
if you were one of those people that are like, ah, I don't care, I'm just gonna give them a cookie cutter protocol and do whatever. I mean, because just like most people know, and it's probably less so in the body in the bikini division, but obviously there's supplement use and stuff like that. You can really hurt somebody if you give them something that's dangerous. And
Yeah,
it
definitely.
happens. It happens. So,
Definitely.
but yeah, do you have anybody that you're like rooting for in the Olympia?
I would say Laura Lee. She's one of my favorite competitors. Laura Lee, I love her physique, and she's coming in with that harder, bigger look. She's still very small, but she's got that muscular shape. Another favorite for me is Maureen Blanquisco. I love her. She's another very tiny competitor. I don't know if you know her. She's
Yeah, I do. I do. I
okay.
do
Yeah,
know her.
she's very, very small. I think she's stunning as well. Deraja is a favorite. Deraja Hill, I believe her last name is.
That sounds
So
familiar.
she won the overall North Americans a few years
Okay.
ago
Yeah, I
and
think I
won
know
her
who you're
first few
talking
pro
about.
shows. Yep, but she's another real big favorite. And then Lauren Dana Miller. I love her.
There's with bikini, it's hard to stay the Olympia champ for quite a while. Like you rarely see, I think Ashley Caldwell has it 3 times, I think, and if I'm not mistaken, that's the record. So it's like unlike other divisions where you can be Olympia champ for 5, 6, 8 years, sometimes it's 3 championships and is a lot. So
Definitely.
one thing is, if you do win multiple or even one, that already kind of solidifies you as a great competitor in that division. The other thing is it allows opportunity, right? So it's like if you don't win 1 year, that doesn't mean you can't win the next year, and I think that's an awesome part of that division as well. So.
I would really love to see. I can't even believe I forgot to mention her. My posing coach, Jasmine Gonzalez. So I would love to see her honestly win the Olympia or potentially take top five in the Olympia just because she's a prior service member. She's in the Marine Corps.
Oh, okay. Very cool.
So I'm
Very
all for our
cool.
military competing in
Yeah, I can
the
see
big
that. Yeah.
sports.
Yeah. Very cool. What about your husband? What division is he in?
So he does men's physique.
Men's physique. Okay, very
Yep,
cool. I
but
see he's an
he doesn't
NPC as
want to stay
well.
in that. He wants to take time off, and he's essentially doing the same thing as I am. He's taking the next 2 years off at a minimum to build
Yeah.
because he would like to potentially go up to classic.
Got it. Got it. Yeah. So, well, I mean, classic, those guys are pretty big. Often they talk about like classic as being like this more aesthetic physique, which is true, but they're not that small. If if anybody's ever seen classic physique show at the high levels, they're pretty big guys. Some
Yeah,
of them
definitely.
can do well, like in the open division, if they wanted to, they want to go up there. So, but very cool. Well, at least you guys are doing it together. That way you can kind of like, kind of bounce ideas off each other and monitor each other and so forth. So.
Honestly, it helps. So I've heard horror stories of couples prepping together
Yeah,
and
I
or
have
one
too.
not being in the sport. And with us, honestly, I think the biggest argument that maybe that we have with each other is who took each other's chicken. That's honestly, it's not hard at all. I feel like it's way easier to prep with him because he has an understanding for it. And he actually got into it because he wanted to understand what it was that I put myself through for these shows. So
So you got into it first, and then he
yeah, so
followed.
I was doing it before he even met me. And then we met while we were deployed, and I did like the first year of our relationship, I was prepping for a show after we came home from our deployment. And that was the first time him ever seeing somebody go through it and watch me just bust my ass every day, even with the military. And he just couldn't, un he wanted to understand how it was and how I had such drive to get it done and accomplish what I wanted to accomplish. So once he saw me win two overalls back to back, he was just like, oh, well, if you did that, I want to see and I want to understand how it is to go through it. And then he did his first show and won the overall. And I was just like, oh, look at this. This is awesome.
Yeah, so he must have a good, pretty good genetics himself if he can win overall off on his first show. So that's
Yeah.
not, can't really do that. It's not easy, I should say, to do that. So very cool. Very cool. Well,
Definitely.
do you, so I know you don't coach. Do you like when people reach out to you, ask questions? The reason I say that is if, you know, if you're okay with that, what would be like the best way for people to reach out to you?
So I mean, I don't mind answering questions, but when it comes to people asking me to like structure things or give them very specific advice, I'm
Right.
not comfortable with that. I'm okay with giving basic answers because I'm not the most knowledgeable person. As much as I do my own research and stuff, I know I'm not the best person to give the answers to. And I like again don't want to put somebody else's safety in my hands. And I don't want somebody to say, well, hey, Alexis told me to do X, Y, and Z. So this is the reason now why I've got X, Y, and Z problems.
Yeah. No, that makes total sense. Well, Alexis, I really appreciate you coming on the show. I look forward to your
Thank
next
you.
competition, even if it's a couple of years
I
removed from
appreciate the
today.
opportunity.
Yeah, of course. So, and again, I wish you and your husband all the best.
Thank you.
Take care.
Take care.